Hello, in this video we are going to investigate how to use the cubic hull generator. The cubic hull generator visualizes the volumetric dataset using cubes, and the result will be looking similar to the result like in Minecraft, and we are also reproducing the scene, a sample of Minecraft today. For this we have here the sprite sheet provided by Minecraft itself. It's not included in the package due to legal reasons, so I add it here for the video now. You can gather it here inside from the web. So now let's create a Minecraft environment. First, we have here our sample scene, and here we have a voxel generator. And here we have a hull generator, which is empty. And now here we are going to add the native Atlas cubic. The word Atlas means that this hull generator uses a sprite Atlas. And this here is a sprite Atlas because it has it is a map which has many, many textures inside here. And the textures can be looked up so by using the X and Y coordinates. And you can define inside the Atlas cubic the amount of rows, which we will set now. I think it is 16. Here you can count the rows. They are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 30, 40, 50, 16. We have 16 rows. Also, we have here a material which is called, I call it Minecraft, and now I'm going to apply this material here, and here we can define our resolution. In this case I keep width and cell subdivision at 8, but I increase the amount of cores we are dedicated to it, so in order to generate the result faster. And now we are going to generate a new block. So what are we seeing here now? Here we can see the sprite of a tree or whatever this is, and this is the sprite at the position 255. If I make this bigger now, it is here the last position here because the initial value is 255, and it goes, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And it goes rows-wise, and this one is the last one. So if I set the initial value to 1 and regenerate it, we have now the ID 1, which is this one here, because this is 0 and this is 1. Now let's paint around, let's sculpt the voxel map here. Here we have the voxel modifier, and if we set this to additive and this to subtractive, and if I paint material, we can see here I move material. Because 0 is empty, and if I add material, we can see here that the ID value changes. And this is how Minecraft works. You have the ID, and if it is increasing or decreasing, it uses a lookup table to evaluate the texture being used for visualization. So in order to paint something useful, we have to change the editor tools a little bit here. We are going to use the Minecraft-like mode, so by left click we are removing material, so I set it to 0, left click, I remove material, and right click, I add material. And to do this, set to any value here, and if I right click now, I'm changing material. This is the wool material, I think. I can even increase it. Let's take another parameter here. This is an empty material or unused. It's also unused. Here, I don't know if what this is. I think this is a fence or whatever. I'm not sure what exactly this material is. Here, these are the end stones. These are the end stones from, I think, the end portal. I'm just going by random now, because I don't know what's exactly here. Here we have the, I think this is a pumpkin or whatever. Yeah, and here you can see in the map here, there are empty spots. I think they were never used or are left to be used because you have 255 options. And I think there is a possibility to have more than 255. I think the mod packs from Minecraft have more than that. And this is achieved if you have, if you use, for example, a second texture, a second dimension, and the second dimension decides which texture map should be used. So it could be basically you could have 255 times 250 times amount of different textures. So if you want to implement Minecraft like game, I highly recommend to implement some tool where you have where you see which ID is which texture here. So here we have the ores. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 times 16, I think. Yeah, in this case, I can just guess here by when I'm using the editor tools. Nope. We have some other textures, yeah. And this is Atlas cubic. We have a cubic representation. And this is it. When we go to the hull generator, we can also increase the width, for example. Also the same. Now we have a much finer structure, or I can increase this amount. Now it's even more fine. So if we go close here, this is the size from the perspective of a Minecraft player. If it has the size like this, you can see how big this block is. Also painting is no problem. I can paint into the world. And you can also use the world generator to procedurally generate the world, but this is content for future. But in this video, you have learned the fundamentals of the cubic hull generator. It's really the most basic one, because it cannot get more basic than cubes. And here we have another tool, which is called solid paint, which means if I right click now, I only change the blocks which are not zero. So this can be used to paint terrain or paint your grass. You can paint this and here this is stone or whatever. So now you have seen a fundamental overview of this hull generator. It's really, really easy to use. You only have this cell subdivision and the amount of cores. It's always the same. And here you have the appearance settings. So, but more than 16 is not possible. It makes no sense because you have you can only have 255 tiles. And here the smooth angle can be used for the normals if I set it to 0. I think I have to rebuild it. We have a different moving angle. So this is it, the hull generator for Cubic. So if you want to build your Minecraft world, I recommend to use this one. And see you later. Bye bye.